is a long time story from the page of history of Albert and Lucy Parsons from the land of opportunity. Tungsten County in Waco, Texas, they spend their lives in Illinois. The helping of the workers, more freedom to enjoy. The march against the robber barons in the year of 85. The railway men and populace soon were terrorized by the plutocrats and pink curtains, vigilantes and red squad. Captain Bond, he'll get the order, shoot the kill. They only wanted blood. That's a labor's union banner. With courage we must stay to celebrate our labor on the 1st of May. Improvement of the worker, their lives did employ. The black rose and red carnation of Chicago, Illinois. Next morning on the newsstand, stories of the cruelest harm in the art by Terrence Zanton. The freckle and alarm for the slaughter of the workers, their clubbing out of hand. Full bitter were the tears of woman, child and man. The movement of the 8-hour day, its time has surely come. When 20,000 factories, their wheels had ceased to hum. Up along Michigan Avenue, Parsons' family led the way. The voices of the workers singing arrived on the 1st of May. The knights of labor's union banner, with courage we must stay to celebrate our labor. Chicago, people there. And next spoke Mr. Parsons to pass on a warning. Say, this could cost me my very life before the coming of the morning. No scabs or wage slavery is the reason for our fight. As Sam Fielding spoke these words, no warning sticker stick up yet in night. The workers mingle in that throng. As evening turned to night, murder had been done. Lights of labor's union banner, with courage we must stay to celebrate our labor on the 1st of May. Their lives did employ the black rose and red carnation of Chicago, Illinois. From the northwoods of Wisconsin, by Pottawatomie Sea, I've returned to the court of justice. of labor's union banner. With courage we must stay to celebrate our labor on the first of May. Improvement of the worker, their lives did employ the black rose and red carnation up to God.